Hi everyone, welcome back to David Ching's Mandarin Impossible channel. In the last lesson, you learned how to tell the time with a 24-hour clock. In today's lesson, let's keep going to learn how to tell the time with a 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese. Before we continue this lesson for today, let's learn the concept for how to tell the time with a 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese.
In English, when telling the time with a 12-hour clock, for example, you may say the time is 8:35 a.m. or 8:35 p.m. 8:35 is the clock time, and a.m. and p.m. are used to indicate the period of time or time period. In English, for telling the time with a 12-hour clock, the sequence is the clock time, and then the time period. However, in Mandarin Chinese, for telling the time with a 12-hour clock, the sequence will be the time period at first, and then the clock time. You can remember the simple concept that Chinese people usually describe things from the biggest area or region to the smallest area or region, such as when expressing place or time. Therefore, when telling the time with a 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese, you can follow the big to small order, time period, and then clock time. Telling the time with a 12-hour clock is commonly used in conversation. For telling the time with a 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese, there are several phrases that Chinese people may often use to indicate the time periods in their daily conversation. I will teach you how to say them in this lesson. For example, when telling the time 8:35 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese, at first, Chinese people may say a proper phrase to express the time period, morning, and then tell the clock time 8:35. Therefore, the literal meaning for the time 8:35 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese is morning, 8:35. When telling the time 8:35 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese, Chinese people may say the proper phrase to express the time period, evening, and then tell the clock time 8:35. Therefore, the literal meaning for the time 8:35 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese is evening, 8:35.
Now, let's see a more detailed explanation for how to tell the time with a 12-hour clock.
For telling the time with a 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese, at first, you need to say the time period with the proper Mandarin Chinese phrase, and then say the 12-hour clock time. Let's focus on the time period in Mandarin Chinese at first. When telling the time with a 12-hour clock, the time period is divided into several parts. The common time periods are before dawn, morning, noon, afternoon, dusk, evening, night, and midnight. Each time period corresponds to one or more Mandarin Chinese phrases, which are commonly used in daily conversation when telling the time with a 12-hour clock. I will teach you how to say them later in this lesson. Now, let's focus on the clock time for the 12-hour clock. On the screen are the rules for telling the time with a 24-hour clock that you learned in the last lesson. For telling the time with a 12-hour clock, the rules are similar to the rules when telling the time with a 24-hour clock. Please pay attention to this. For telling the time with a 12-hour clock, the numbers in the hour position are not from 0 to 24. Instead, the numbers in the hour position are from 1 to 12. With the time period phrases and the 12-hour clock time, you can tell the time with a 12-hour clock.
Now, let's learn how to tell the time with a 12-hour clock, starting with the time period. Before dawn.
On the screen is the time 3:07 a.m. For telling the time 3:07 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period before dawn. For expressing the time period before dawn in Mandarin Chinese, you can say 凌晨. 凌 has many meanings in Mandarin Chinese. For telling the time, 凌 means approach. 凌 is the second tone. Please pronounce it after me.
凌 凌 凌
晨 means morning. 晨 is the second tone. Please pronounce it after me.
晨 晨 晨
Therefore, 凌晨 literally means approach morning, the time approaching morning. 凌晨 can be used to indicate the time period before dawn. Please pronounce it after me.
凌晨 凌晨 凌晨
For telling the time, 3:07 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 3:07, right after the phrase 凌晨. Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time 3:07 a.m. is pronounced 凌晨 三 点 零七 分 Let's pronounce it one more time 凌晨 三 点 零七 分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character, like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters, like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
凌晨3:07分 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 Now, let's learn to tell the time with a time period. Morning.
On the screen is the time, 8:45 a.m. For telling the time, 8:45 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, morning. For expressing the time period, morning, in Mandarin Chinese, there are two ways to say it. Let's learn the first one. 上午 Shang has many meanings in Mandarin Chinese. In this case, 上 means upward. 上 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
上
午 means noon. 午 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
午
If you put these two characters together, 上午 literally means upward, noon, the time right before noon. Therefore, 上午 indicates the time period, morning. Please pronounce it after me.
上午
For telling the time, 8:45 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 8:45, right after the phrase 上午. Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time, 8:45 a.m. is pronounced 上午8:45分. Let's pronounce it one more time. 上午8:45分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character, like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters, like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
上午8:45分 Just now you learned the phrase 上午 Now let's keep going to learn another common phrase to express the time period, morning. It is 早上。
There is also another common way to express the time period, morning. It is 早上。早 has more than one meaning. In this case, 早 means early or morning. 早 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
早早早
The character 上 also has more than one meaning. In this case, 上 indicates a range, certain aspect, or certain time period. 上 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
上上上
If you put these two characters together, 早上 literally means early aspect or early range. Therefore, 早上 indicates the time period, morning. Please pronounce it after me.
早上早上早上
For telling the time, 8:45 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 8:45, right after the phrase, 早上 Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time, 8:45 a.m. is pronounced. 早上八点四十五分 Let's pronounce it one more time.早上八点四十五分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
早上八点四十五分早上八点四十五分早上八点四十五分 Now, let's learn to tell the time with the time period. Noon.
On the screen is the time, 12:30 p.m. For telling the time, 12:30 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, noon. For expressing the time period, noon, in Mandarin Chinese, you can say it,中午 The character 中 has many meanings. The common meanings of 中 are middle and central. 中 is the first tone. Please pronounce it after me.
中中中
午 means noon. 午 is the third tone.Please pronounce it after me.
午午午
In ancient China, for telling the time, people used 12 characters, which individually indicated a unique part of the day. Let's see one example and explain it with modern clock time. In ancient China, each character indicated a unique 2-hour part of the day.And one of the characters, 午, indicated the part of the day from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. The result of this example is that now, in modern Chinese, for telling the time, 午 is commonly used to represent the time period around 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. In modern Chinese, 午 combined with the character 中 as 中午 literally means middle noon. However, in this case, 中午 indicates the time period noon, which is around 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Please pronounce it after me.
中午中午中午
For telling the time, 12:30 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese,Let's put the 12-hour clock time, 12:30, right after the phrase, 中午 Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time, 12:30 p.m. is pronounced. 中午十二点三十分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 中午十二点三十分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
中午十二点三十分中午十二点三十分中午十二点三十分 Now, let's learn to tell the time with a time period. Afternoon.
On the screen is the time, 2:33 p.m. For telling the time, 2:33 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, afternoon. For expressing the time period, afternoon, in Mandarin Chinese, you can say it, 下午. The character 下 has many meanings. In this case, 下 means downward. 下 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
下下下
午 means noon. 午 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
午午午
If you put these two characters together, 下午literally means the time downward from noon, the time right after noon. Therefore, 下午 indicates the time period afternoon. Please pronounce it after me.
下午下午下午
For telling the time, 2:33 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 2:33, right after the phrase 下午 Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time 2:33 p.m. is pronounced 下午两点三十三分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 下午两点三十三分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
下午两点三十三分下午两点三十三分下午两点三十三分 Now, let's learn to tell the time with the time period. Dusk.
On the screen is the time, 5:46 p.m. For telling the time, 5:46 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, dusk, to express the time before night when it is not yet dark. For expressing the time period, dusk, in Mandarin Chinese, in Taiwan, people pronounce it bang wǎn. In China, people pronounce it bang wǎn. The character bang or bang has many meanings. In this case, it means be close to or near. Bang is the first tone. Please pronounce it after me.
Bang bang bang
bang is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
Bang bang bang
晚 means late or evening. 晚 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
晚晚晚
If you put these two characters together, 傍晚安 or 傍晚安 literally means the time is close to evening or the time is near evening. Therefore, 傍晚安 or 傍晚安 indicates the time period, dusk, which is the time before night when it is not yet dark. In Taiwan, people pronounce it as 傍晚安 Please pronounce it after me.
傍晚安傍晚安傍晚安
In mainland China, people pronounce it as 傍晚安 Please pronounce it after me.
傍晚安傍晚安傍晚安
For telling the time, 5:46 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 5:46, right after the phrase 傍晚安 or 傍晚安 Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time 5:46 p.m. in Taiwan is pronounced 傍晚安五点四十六分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 傍晚安五点四十六分 And the time 5:46 p.m. in China is pronounced 傍晚安五点四十六分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 傍晚安五点四十六分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
傍晚五点四十六分傍晚五点四十六分傍晚五点四十六分傍晚五点四十六分傍晚五点四十六分傍晚五点四十六分 Now, let's learn to tell the time with a time period. Evening.
On the screen is the time 6:58 p.m. For telling the time 6:58 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, evening. For expressing the time period, evening, in Mandarin Chinese, you can say it 晚上晚安means late or evening. 晚安 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
晚安晚安晚安
The character 上 in this case indicates a range, certain aspect, or certain time period. 上 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
上上上
If you put these two characters together, 晚上 literally means late aspect or late range. Therefore, the phrase 晚上 can be used to indicate a time period, evening. Please pronounce it after me.
晚上晚上晚上
For telling the time, 6:58 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 6:58, right after the phrase, 晚上 Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time 6:58 p.m. is pronounced 晚上六点五十八分 Let's pronounce it one more time.晚上六点五十八分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character, like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters, like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
晚上六点五十八分。晚上六点五十八分。晚上六点五十八分。
Now, let's learn to tell the time with the time period. Night.
On the screen is the time, 10:22 p.m. For telling the time, 10:22 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, night. For expressing the time period, night, in Mandarin Chinese, you can say it, 晚上, which is the same as the phrase you just learned for the time period, evening. Let's review the meaning of 晚上 again. 晚安 means late or evening. The character 上 in this case indicates a range, a certain aspect, or certain time period. 晚上 literally means late aspect or late range. In Mandarin Chinese, the phrase 晚上can be used to indicate both time periods, evening and night. In this case, the phrase 晚上 is used to indicate the time period, night. Please pronounce it after me.
晚上晚上晚上
For telling the time, 10:22 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 10:22, right after the phrase, 晚上. Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time 10:22 p.m. is pronounced. 晚上十点二十二分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 晚上十点二十二分 Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character, like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters, like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
晚上十点二十二分。晚上十点二十二分。晚上十点二十二分。
Now, let's learn to tell the time with the time period. Midnight.
On the screen is the time, 12:03 a.m. For telling the time, 12:03 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period, midnight. There are several ways to express the time period, midnight. I will only introduce two common phrases in this lesson. For the first phrase to express the time period, midnight, in Mandarin Chinese, you can say 半夜. 半 means half. 半 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
半半半
In this case, 夜 means night. 夜 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
夜夜夜
Therefore, 半夜 literally means half night, halfway through the night. 半夜 can be used to indicate the time period, midnight, which is around 12 a.m. Please pronounce it after me.
半夜半夜半夜
For telling the time, 12:03 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 12:03, right after the phrase, 半夜. Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, the time, 12:03 a.m. is pronounced. 半夜十二点零三分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 半夜 十二点零三分。Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character, like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters, like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
半夜十二点零三分。半夜十二点零三分。半夜十二点零三分。
There is also another way to express the time period, midnight. It is 午夜。
Another way to express the time period, midnight, is 午夜。午 means noon. 午 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
午午午
In this case, 夜 means night. 夜 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
夜夜夜
If you put these two characters together, 午夜 literally means noon night. The middle of the night, which is like the noon time in the middle of the day. Therefore,午夜 indicates the time period, midnight. Please pronounce it after me.
午夜午夜午夜
For telling the time, 12:03 a.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time, 12:03, right after the phrase 午夜 Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson,The time 12:03 a.m. is pronounced. 午夜十二点零三分 Let's pronounce it one more time. 午夜十二点零三分Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character, like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters, like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
午夜十二点零三分。午夜十二点零三分。午夜十二点零三分。
Just now, you learned how to tell the 12-hour clock time with the time period phrases. Now, let's keep going to learn two more individual characters that Chinese people may use when telling the time.
These two characters are 整 and 半. When saying the clock time, the character 整, which means complete, whole, or full,can be used to express the sharp hours of the clock, or when the time is exactly on the hour without any minutes or seconds. 整 is the third tone. Please pronounce it after me.
整整整
On the screen are the sharp hours of the clock. In Mandarin Chinese, you say these clock times as...一点两点三点四点五点六点七点八点九点十点十一点 and 十二点 When you want to emphasize the clock time that is exactly on the hour without any minutes or seconds,You can add the character 整 right after each clock time like what you see on the screen. You can say these clock times as 一点整两点整三点整四点整五点整六点整七点整八点整九点整十点整十一点整 and 12点整.
Let's see an example for how to tell the time 4 p.m. sharp with the character 整.
On the screen is the time 4 p.m. sharp. For telling the time 4 p.m. sharp in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period afternoon. For expressing the time period afternoon in Mandarin Chinese, you can say it 下午. For telling the time 4 p.m. sharp in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time 4 o'clock right after the phrase 下午. Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, and adding the character 整 at the end, the time 4 p.m. sharp is pronounced 下午 4点整. Let's pronounce it one more time. 下午 4点整. Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, it is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
下午4点整 下午4点整 下午4点整
Now, let's keep going to learn how to use the character 半 to tell the time.
When saying the clock time, the character 半, which means half, can be used to express the time at the half hours of the clock. 半 is the fourth tone. Please pronounce it after me.
半 半 半
On the screen are the times at the half hours of the clock. In Mandarin Chinese, you can say these clock times as 1点30分 2点30分 3点30分 4点30分 5点30分 6点30分 7点30分 8点30分 9点30分 10点30分 11点30分 and 12点30分. In conversation, which is not an official way to tell the time, you can replace 30分 with one character, 半, like what you see on the screen. Therefore, you can say these clock times as 1点半 2点半 3点半 4点半 5点半 6点半 7点半 8点半 9点半 10点半 11点半 and 12点半.
Now, let's see an example for how to tell the time 4:30 p.m. with the character 半.
On the screen is the time 4:30 p.m. For telling the time 4:30 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock, you can use the time period afternoon. For expressing the time period afternoon in Mandarin Chinese, you can say it 下午. For telling the time 4:30 p.m. in Mandarin Chinese, let's put the 12-hour clock time 4:30 right after the phrase 下午. Then, with the rules you learned from the last lesson, and hiding and replacing the Arabic numeral 30 and the character 分 with the character 半, the time 4:30 p.m. is pronounced 下午4 点半. Let's pronounce it one more time. 下午4点半. Each sound you just pronounced corresponds to a Mandarin Chinese character like what you see on the screen. In modern Mandarin Chinese, It is also commonly represented by Arabic numerals with the Mandarin Chinese characters like what you see on the screen. Please pronounce it after me.
下午4点半 下午4点半 下午4点半
Just now, you learned how to tell the time with a 12-hour clock in conversation. Now, let's keep going to learn how the 12-hour clock time is expressed in Mandarin Chinese on electronic devices and computer systems.
On the screen are the Mandarin Chinese time period phrases you just learned. These phrases are used very often in conversation. However, when electronic devices and computer systems are set to use Mandarin Chinese and a 12-hour clock to express the time, the time period AM is only represented with the characters 上午, and the time period PM is only represented with the characters 下午. You can simply remember that the literal meaning of 上午 is upward noon, the time before noon, and it means AM on the computer. The literal meaning of 下午 is downward noon, the time after noon, and it means PM on the computer. Therefore, on a computer system set to use Mandarin Chinese and using a 12-hour clock to express the time, when you see the phrase 上午 with the time 2:06 on the computer, it means the time is 2:06 a.m. When you see the phrase 下午 with the time 2:06 on the computer, it means the time is 2:06 p.m.
Now that you have learned how to tell the time with a 12-hour clock, let's have a comprehensive review of this lesson.
For telling the time with a 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese, the time period is always expressed before the clock time. The common time periods are before dawn, morning, noon, afternoon, dusk, evening, night, and midnight. In Mandarin Chinese, they are 凌晨, 上午, or 早上, 中午, 下午, 傍晚, or 傍晚, 晚上, 晚上, and 半夜, or 午夜. For the computer system, which is said to use Mandarin Chinese and a 12-hour clock, the time periods are only represented with two phrases, 上午 and 下午. 上午 means AM and 下午 means PM. For the clock time, the rules are similar to what you learned from the last lesson about 24-hour clock. The only difference for the 12-hour clock is that the possible numbers for the hour position are only from 1 to 12. For expressing the clock time, when the time is on the sharp hours of the clock or the half hours of the clock, you can also use the characters 整 or 半, which are often used in conversation. Let's take 7 o'clock and 7:30 as the example. For saying 7 o'clock, you can say it in Mandarin Chinese as 七点. For saying 7 o'clock sharp, you can add one more character, 整, right after 七点. Therefore, for saying 7 o'clock sharp, you can say it as 七点整. For saying 7:30, you can say it in Mandarin Chinese as 七点三十分. For saying 7:30, you can also replace the characters 三十分 with the character 半. Therefore, for saying 7:30, you can also say it as 七点半.
Now, let's have a comprehensive test of this lesson.
There are 5 questions in this test. On the left-hand side are the flashcards represented with 12-hour clock time. As soon as each car turns, please tell the time with 12-hour clock in Mandarin Chinese. Let's begin. Question number 1. Let's check the answer.
下午4点26分。下午4点26分。下午4点26分。
Question number 2. Let's check the answer.
上午8点01分。上午8点01分。上午8点01分。
There is also another Chinese time period to tell this time. Let's check the answer.
早上8点01分。早上8点01分。早上8点01分。
Question number 3. Let's check the answer.
晚上9点30分。晚上9点30分。晚上9点30分。
There is also another common way to tell this time. Let's check the answer.
晚上9点半。晚上9点半。晚上9点
半。Question number 4. Let's check the answer.
凌晨3点20分。凌晨3点20分。凌晨3点20分。
Question number 5. Let's check the answer.
半夜12点48分。半夜12点48分。半夜12点48分。
There is also another way to tell this time. Let's check the answer.
午夜12点48分。午夜12点48分。午夜12点48分。
Now, let's try another test.
There are 5 questions in this test. Please write down what you hear or see into Arabic numerals with the hour, minute, and time period, AM or PM format, like what you see on the screen. Let's begin. Question number 1.
中午12点整。中午12点整。中午12点整。
Let's check the answer. Question number 2.
傍晚5点18分。傍晚5点18分。傍晚5点18分。傍晚5点18分。傍晚5点18分。傍晚5点18分。
Let's check the answer. Question number 3. This is a photo of a Taiwanese local street vendor selling egg cakes. In this photo, there is a signboard that contains 2 opening times, one for the morning and one for the afternoon. What is the morning opening time for the street vendor? Let's check the answer. Question number 4. This is a screenshot from a computer system set up to use Mandarin Chinese with a 12-hour clock. Each file has its own update time. What is the update time for the circled file? Let's check the answer. Question number 5.
晚上十点半。
Let's check the answer.
This is the end of the class for today. See you next time. 再见。